Okay, so now that you've marked this as the first image that the user will see when they open up your tour, let me show you something else here. You can go ahead and click on the photo, and then you see there it says drag to reorder. So by clicking on those four, you can rearrange your photos like this. Now, this just makes it easier for you to find them. All right, so go ahead and move that back here. Okay, that slider down at the bottom is a little tricky to use, so good luck with that. Now, here, let's go ahead. Now that we have this first one, let me explain what we have over here. So, you have your information. This is basic information about the tour. Then, Panorama's movement. This one here, if you notice, when you turn the pictures like this, it has just a little bit of what we call slide at the end. Now you can have it stay that way or you can adjust it. So let's go ahead and you know what? We're going to move that right there. And you can, if you turn it off like that, click here, that's enabled, that's disabled. You can see the difference there when it's enabled and when it's not. So we're going to bink, go ahead and enable it like that. And then you can even adjust. You see the amount of slide you have here? If you set it very, very soft, when you move, it will continue to carry just a little bit. It just depends on what you like. Hard, again, is really stiff. Okay? All right, so somewhere in the middle, their default settings are fine for what we need also. Okay? All right, so let's go ahead then and move on. Now we have this. You'll notice also Panorama backwards auto-linking. Later, as we begin to add hotspots, we'll be making use of that. Here is also where you can add the sound. Now, you can have one audio file per slide. Geolocalization, let me go ahead and show. If you really want to show somebody where you are in the world, you can enter that. And you can see they have a map there for you. You can try to find where you are, but it's going to start us somewhere in Africa. So moving it to ourselves here might be a bit of a trick. All right. Okay, so now that we have this one here, let's go ahead then and go on to Panorama Properties. Now, here you can change the title and the name of the pictures. You can change the thumbnail that it looks like. You can share the image, but you don't need to, right? And again, that geolocalization is here too. All right. Here is something that you're going to need though. This, sometimes when you have your 360 photos and you upload them, they might be facing the wrong way. All you have to do in Theasys is just go ahead and turn the picture to where you want it to be seen, and then you're going to say the panorama 0 point. So adjust. Do you see that? That is where it is. So here, let's go ahead and arrange it so that people can see it this way. Okay. And set as default view. You'll see there it's successful. Let's go ahead and test it. Move it just a little bit, click test. Oh, there you go. That way, when the user opens your photo, they'll be able to see it from there.